I call the Honourable Member Mojo Mathers.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I rise to speak on behalf of the Green Party to talk about inequality and disability. The recent census shows that nearly 1 in 4 New Zealanders live with a disability, up from 1 in 5 in the previous census. And these figures include some of the most marginalised people in New Zealand, especially those who have had a disability since birth. Disabled people are seriously underrepresented in paid employment and experience correspondingly higher levels of poverty as a result. And this poverty is absolutely dire for many disabled people who often have no resources and no buffers to cope with long-term lack of income. The figures are stark. For example, let's look at home ownership. In New Zealand, the rate of home ownership for the average population is 64.8%. In contrast, only 52% of disabled adults own or partly own a home. However, when we look at those who have been disabled from birth, the rate of home ownership drops to 27%. That's less than half the rate of the average population. Can you imagine the outcry that would exist if less than 1 in 3 New Zealanders owned their own home? And yet that is the reality for those who live with a disability from birth. And it shows just how systematic the barrier that disabled people face in every level of society from birth onwards that they face and that ends up with their being unable to access their own home. As a signatory to the United Nations Convention on the Rights of Disabled People, government has an absolute responsibility to step up and remove barriers to participation for disabled people. And it must take this responsibility seriously. For disabled people do have so much that they can contribute, but because they're locked out of paid employment and face a lifetime of rejection, no matter how skilled or qualified they become, they still face rejection and difficulty accessing paid employment. And I've spoken with disabled people from throughout the country who are desperate to be active productive participants in the paid workforce, and many have valuable skills. And Be Accessible, which is an organisation that works in disability issues, estimates that the opportunity cost of workforce exclusion of people with disability is $11.7 billion in New Zealand. That is the economic value of the work that they could be contributing but are not able to because of the barriers that are in place to paid employment. And so one of the immediate steps that this government could do is step up and prioritise providing paid employment opportunities for disabled people. And one obvious place that the government can start is with the public sector. A best practice model from the government and employment in the public sector will have massive direct benefit and also serve as encouragement for the private sector to follow suit. The public sector still remains the biggest employer in New Zealand with over 36,000 frontline paid staff. And at the moment, most government departments do not have active specific initiatives aimed at identifying and recruiting people with disability, even just into the potential labour pool. And that means that many disabled people don't even get a foot in the door. It is time for government to step up. And what the Green Party believes is that the public sector needs to lead the way by being a positive employer for disabled people by amending the State Sector Act to place stronger emphasis on the responsibility of the state sector to give disabled people an equal chance to get a job. And in doing so, there's the act of thinking about how can we do this? How can we remove barriers? This will become more aware and set up a positive cycle of reinforcement. And This is something that I would like the government to absolutely look into seriously, something that disabled people have called for time and time again, because it would have so many dire flow-through effects on the whole culture and attitude of the country as a whole towards disabled people, towards recognising our skills and our abilities and getting them actively included into the economy and into government. Thank you.
I'm advised the